The College of William and Mary was founded on February 8, 1693, under a royal charter issued by King William III and Queen Mary II of England. Located in Williamsburg, Virginia, it is the second oldest institution of higher education in the United States. William and Mary became a private college after it separated from England during the American War for Independence in 1776. Today, it is a public research university, and its campus is full of history, mysteries, and hauntings. Tucker Hall has a strange connection to the high number of suicides at William & Mary. In 2015, there were four different student suicides out of 8,000 students who attended. Tucker Hall was originally built as a library, then housed the law department for 13 years before becoming home to the English department. During the 1980s, a girl hung herself on the third floor of Tucker Hall after a long night of studying. A few years later, another student was found hanging in the exact same spot with a note that only said, "She made me do it." In 2004, a man killed himself in the building. Many have reported a strange girl who comes up to those pulling an all-nighter in the building and asks how their study's going. If the student says fine, she'll tell them they should call it a night and head to bed. If the student doesn't listen, the girl throws a fit and slams her hands on the walls and tables until they leave. If the student responds that studying is not going well, and they think they may fail, the girl tries to convince them to kill themselves to solve all their problems and shortcomings in life. PBK Hall is named after the Phi Beta Kappa Society, the oldest honor society in the United States that was founded at William & Mary in 1776. PBK Hall is the main performing arts building on campus and was built in 1953 to replace the original theater that burned down. Soon after the new hall was built, a girl who was rehearsing to be a lead in the play died while visiting home. Late one night, the new lead was rehearsing for the play alone and found the dress for the lead role sitting upright in one of the front row seats. Strange noises are often heard throughout PBK, and those who are brave enough to follow the noises are led to the same dress that keeps mysteriously appearing throughout the building. The Wren Building was built in 1700 and is the oldest academic building in continuous use in the United States. Each year, tradition has incoming freshmen pass through the building and out into the courtyard. Seniors walk through the opposite direction on their way to the graduation ceremony. However, students aren't the only ones who have passed through the halls of the Wren Building. The building was used as a hospital by both the French Army during the War for Independence and the Confederate Army during the American Civil War. The building has been burned and been rebuilt from three different fires that left only the outer walls standing. Sounds of mysterious footsteps can be heard pacing the building, and a mysterious figure is often spotted on the third floor that is thought to be the ghost of a French soldier. Beneath the Wren Chapel is a crypt that contains beloved colonial governor Lord Botetourt and other distinguished Virginians. One way into the crypt is through the old steam tunnels that run throughout the old campus, warming the buildings with steam and connecting them with internet and phone lines. The tunnels have been used by many of the fraternities and secret societies on campus for their initiation rituals throughout the years. William and Mary has at least 9 known secret societies that focus on the betterment of the college through philanthropy of a clandestine nature. Brafferton is the second oldest building on campus and was originally built for the Indian School. The school was meant to civilize Native American boys by teaching them how to read and write, eventually preparing them to be cultural liaisons or Anglican priests for their tribes. Many of the boys tried to escape, leading them to being locked in Brafferton at night. You can still hear their suffering with phantom footsteps, woeful moans, and sobbing coming from the building at night. One Native American fashioned a rope out of bedsheets to escape and run free each night. He was never disciplined because he always returned. However, one night he vanished and was never seen again, leading many to believe that he was killed during the night. Sometimes on a misty night, an Indian boy can be seen running a few feet off the ground through the sunken gardens. He appears to be floating because the sunken garden was not sunken, but rather level with the rest of the campus when he was alive. The President's House is the official residence for the President of William and Mary. Every president has resided there except for one. The home has entertained many presidents of the United States, including George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, and James Madison, along with notable foreign visitors that include Queen Elizabeth II, Prince Philip, Winston Churchill, and Prince Charles. The home contains many mysteries and secrets from its past. A bedroom on the third floor has a closet door that would always stay open, no matter what the president's family did to keep it closed. During one of the building's renovations, there was a skeleton of a child discovered pressed into the brick wall of that same old closet. No one has solved the mystery of who the skeleton belonged to or how it ended up in the closet. After the skeleton was removed, the closet door stayed shut. The house was used by French soldiers as a hospital when the Rennes building was overflowing with wounded during the War of Independence. When the campus was captured by the Union Army during the Civil War, it was used as a prison for the Confederate soldiers. It is haunted by what is thought to be a French soldier that wanders the second and third floor of the home. The front door is known to open and slam shut, and footsteps of an unseen entity can be heard coming up and down the steps. Anyone visiting the Williamsburg area should check out the College of William and Mary. The Rennes Building, President's House, and Brafferton are a short walk from Colonial Williamsburg, so it makes it easy to see a lot in one day. However, we wouldn't recommend being on the third floor of these buildings late at night. You never know what strange things you may encounter. Thanks, strangers, for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe to our channel for more strange content every Wednesday. Also, check the video description below for additional reading and sources for this video. And until next time, stay strange.